it with the drum attached. You a taco, we got drums for that. Tryna fist fight, boy, you dumb for that.
Stupid.
You gon' get a bullet in your lung for that.
Stupid.
Draco get the kicking like Liu Kang.
Hawk vs. Robby in Season 3, who wins? Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another video. And today, I'll be going through who would win the fight between Season 3 Hawk vs. Season 3 Robby. Reasons and why I'm doing this matchup is that people may think the answer should be obvious or it's a bit controversial, but that's why in today's video I'll be going through the feats and scaling for both fighters and know who I actually think would win the fight. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video and without no hesitations, let's get straight into it. In terms of their strength, I will be referring to their attack potency. And while Hawk was able to break the likes of Dimitri's arm and flip Doug Ray into a glass table, but those feats wouldn't really matter because it isn't match up to anything no more compared to how Robby has done. Cause while Robby got a strike first and from Kreese, he was able to knock out Sean for a few seconds with a kick to the face, and he was able to neg Sean's friends with ease. And as for their durability, it should scale to their AP due by Newton's third law, which states that for every action slash force is a natural there is an equal or an opposite reaction. And throughout Season 3, Hawk's durability wasn't known as being that impressive, because it literally just takes one kick from Sean just to stagger him and just decides to go on to fight a weaker opponent like Dimitri. And as for Robby's case, in his first encounter with Sean, we know that his post-season 2 self was literally screaming from Sean's attacks. And in their second fight, Robby was literally able to withstand attacks from Sean directly in his already bruised face. In Season 3, Hawk was basically regarded to be the best fighter in the Cobra Kai dojo, and he was stated to be the best in the dojo by Kreese himself.
But first, we're going to need to strengthen our core. With Diaz out, we're going to need a new champion. Someone with no fear. And no mercy.
So Hawk would be the strongest in the Cobra Kai dojo, and that will come with both fighters such as Tori, Doug, and Kyler. And his training under Kreese has also made him more an aggressive and offensive fighter. But however, it does show that Hawk's skills do have limits, since in the arcade fight, while having Doug by his side, he couldn't even land an attack on Sam. And we do know that Sam does have knowledge of other Miyagi-Do techniques, such as the drum technique, which didn't feel threatening enough to use it. And as for Robby, he would be the first student in Season 3 to both use Cobra Kai and Miyagi-Do, since Robby was able to use his Miyagi-Do moves offensively by striking first. And he was basically implied to use it, since we see Kreese visit Robby in Juvie. Kreese is basically explaining to him saying that now that you're in the real world, you can't be relying on defense all the time, you may want to think to strike first. And we see that Robby was able to adapt Cobra Kai very easily. And we do see in some brief moment that we do see Robby training with Kreese in the dojo, therefore Robby will be the more versatile fighter, and he will show more skills than more than anything that we see Hawk perform, so therefore Robby takes skill. As for statements, Kreese stated that Hawk was meant to be the next champion for Cobra Kai.
But first, we're going to need to strengthen our core. With Diaz out, we're going to need a new champion. Someone with no fear. And no mercy.
So with that statement alone, does that mean Hawk is above Robby? Well, not exactly, since we do see Kreese make a lot of other statements throughout Season 3. Like when Robby joined the dojo, he implied to Hawk saying what the All Valley back on, we need more as much strength that we can get.
One of us.
With the All Valley back on, we need as much strength as we can get.
We don't.
So with that statement, it's not that Kreese is not saying that Hawk is still his champion. He's just saying that with the All Valley back on, and Robby is just there for additional strength. And then later on, we hear Kreese saying to Robby, you've been what Cobra Kai has been looking for.
You're what Cobra Kai has been looking for.
But therefore, with that statement alone, we'll put Robby above Hawk.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine. And you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
Anyway, in terms of feats, it's pretty much shown in Season 3 that Hawk has not shown like any impressive feats or just lax feats in general, since he was able to beat the likes of Dimitri, Brooks, and pretty much every background character that was in the house fight. And as for Robby, we see that he was able to beat Sean in their fight, and we see in Season 4 Episode 1, we see his post-Season 3 self was able to solve the dojo. So in conclusion, who winning Season 3 Hawk vs Season 3 Robby? Well, if you haven't been watching throughout the whole entire video, and if you have, well, this answer shouldn't be too difficult for all of you that are watching. The winner is Robby. I just mainly think that Robby wins this fight. It's just mainly because that he has shown way better feats and way better scaling than Hawk. Because
Hawk just lacks feats in general, and he just has very vague scaling, and he's very father as f***. So yeah, Hawk basically loses against Robby, and Robby takes the W. Alright everyone, that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Let me know down in the comments if you agree or disagree with my take on this, because as usual, I'd like to hear your thoughts and ideas. I know this video took so long to upload because I've been busy throughout the whole couple of weeks. So I'm just going to say, whenever I do decide to upload a video, I'm going to actually like upload them when I say I'm going to upload, because every time when I say that I'm going to upload a video, I just leave it for like a whole few weeks and I probably forget to do it, and that's because I'm probably busy. Then I just upload and edit that very late. So when I do say I'm going to upload a video, that's when I'm actually going to do it and not just leave it for a whole couple of weeks. Alright everyone, I'm going to shut up now. Make sure to leave a like in the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to the channel if you're new. We'll turn on all notifications so you don't miss when I post a brand new video. And have a nice day everybody.